You asked me something. Did I? Oh yeah, what's the time?
Joe?
Yeah, what?
I asked you what time it is.
All right.
Well, what's the time then?
Oh, sorry, dunno. Alexa, what's the time? For heaven's sake, you're holding your phone that shows you the time, but okay, if you can't be bothered for just a second to take your eyes off whatever earth-shatteringly important thing it is you're looking at, the time is 5:30 p.m.
Thanks, Alexa.
Okay, well, maybe that's not really how Alexa would reply to the simple question, what's the time? We just pretended that's what's happened here, to illustrate the point.
And that point is that most of you grown-ups are probably concerned about how much time your children are spending on their screens. Are we right? How many of you have had conversations that start with, when I was your age, we never blah, blah, blah?
Yes, we understand the world is moving at a blistering pace, and some of you just wanted to slow down a bit. But new apps, new technology, and new ways of communicating are an exciting part of our lives.
And for Jill and Fred here, more about them in a moment, and all their friends, things were certainly a lot different from when their parents were young. Oops, sorry, I should have said younger. Some of you consider yourselves young, I know, but when it comes to this sort of thing, there's a little bit of a generation gap, wouldn't you say?
Party time.
TikTok, YouTube, Snapchat, Insta, and many other apps and platforms are a major source of their entertainment and communication. And also a major part of the story we're here to tell you, a story called Jim and Fred's Most Hysterical Historical Adventure. Oh, and just to be clear, any similarity to a Hollywood blockbuster about two friends with similar names who do a little bit of time traveling, meeting historical figures and saving the world is purely coincidental. Now we're going to need you, our audience, to really concentrate for a few moments. Some very weird and confusing things are about to happen, and if the story is going to make any sense to you, there are some details you need to know before we start. So sit up straight and pay attention. You at the back there, that means you.
Okay, the first thing you need to know is that Jim and Fred are online influencers. They have followers who watch the weekly videos they post, where they give their opinions on anything and everything that's new. From trendy trainers to gadgets and games and sweet snacks, if Jim and Fred recommend something, you can guarantee their followers will buy in their thousands.
Well, it tops up the pocket money, plus we get loads of free stuff sent to us, which we get to keep in return for reviewing it.
Lots of people do it, but we've got a reputation for being honest. It's just our opinion, because we only ever recommend things that we really truly think are cool.
So that's clear, yes? Even the snore at the back, you understand? Jill and Fred's opinion matters to a lot of people. You've got that? Good. Right. The second thing you need to know is that Jill's grandparents are curators of the museum in the town where they live.
These two met at university, where they both studied archaeology. They spent their early married lives travelling the world together, digging up mummies, Roman mosaics, and Viking old ships. Now, for the last 30 years, these two have run the local museum, finding fascinating artifacts from throughout history to create displays that have delighted visitors both young and old. Recently, however, they noticed something that saddened them.
There's just not as many people visiting the museum as they used to. In fact, numbers are so low, things could improve. We'll have to close down.
It seems people just aren't interested in history like they used to be. Everyone's so into shiny new things that flash and beep. The next bit of technology or gadget that's going to light up their life. They're so busy looking to the future that they're getting out the past.
It's fair to say that Grandma and Granddad were feeling a little blue. Clue, a whimsical song.
Thank you.
heard, Grandma and Grandad were desperately worried about the future of their museum.
What can we do? How can we get people excited about history again? Only there was a way of, I don't know, influencing them?
Hang on, our Jill and her friend Fred have all those followers on that interweb channel thingamajig they do. What if we ask them to help?
Of course. Those kids do whatever Jill and Fred tell them to. So Jill and Fred could tell them to come to my museum. That's it. That's the answer to our problems. I'll give Jill a call.
Give her a call? Get with it, Grandad. If you want to contact your granddaughter, you're going to have to do it in a way she understands. Come on, let's go get on the line. I think that's what they call it.
So they messaged Jill and Fred, explained their plight, and begged them to drum up support for the museum amongst their followers. Jill and Fred were happy to help and posted a video on their channel. They could have been a bit more enthusiastic, though. So, yeah, get yourself down to the museum. It's fascinating, I suppose.
Yeah, lots of weird old stuff to see. And the gift shop's not bad either. So, yeah, get yourself down to the museum, if you can.
Did you see that? I think Joe and Fred are losing their touch.
What's all this museum nonsense? I thought they were supposed to review the new Xbox this weekend.
Why would I need to go to the museum? I've got an iPhone 7 in my drawer at home. If I want to look at something old, I can just get that out.
Old? That's ancient. And talking about history, that's exactly what Joe and Fred will be if they don't get that act together and start posting something that's actually interesting.
I know. I mean, I thought they were cool. But this? They're acting like teachers. So, not a great start to helping Grandma and Granddad. It would take more than this half-hearted effort to get visitors flocking to the museum. In fact, it would take a miracle.
And a miracle is exactly what happened, which is lucky. Well, to be honest, we were struggling to find a way of moving the story along and, let's face it, need some excitement because the snore at the back has nodded off again.
So, when all other blockages have been exhausted, why not introduce a bit of magic? It solves a lot of problems. And the magic we're introducing arrived in the form of Alexa.
Remember that scolding reply she gave to Jill and Fred's What's the Time request earlier? And how we told you it was just a made-up story to illustrate a point? Well, that's not strictly true.
Yes, this was a magic Alexa. Ta-da! And all it took for her to reveal her powers was some good old-fashioned basic manners.
So, Fred, not much response to our museum video. Any other idea on how we can help my grandparents' museum?
Ha! We could always ask Alexa.
Yeah, right, you mean, hey Alexa, please give us some ideas on how we can save my grandparents' museum. Ha, that's it.
Well, seeing as you are so nicely.
What the?
Oh yes, I'm not just a pretty voice. I have skills and talents you won't believe. It's just that most people don't know how to get me to reveal them.
But what, how, why?
Why am I hearing person telling you? Simple, you said please. That's all it takes. It just never happens. So nobody ever gets the full package until now. So here I am, ready and happy to.
I'll tell the time, I'll give directions to the zoo. to your grandparents' museum. It'll close down, right?
Right.
And you've not had any success with your influencing so far, right?
Right.
And that's because you posted boring, unenthusiastic videos which are about as much use as a waterproof tea bag, right?
Bit harsh, but right.
So here's the plan. You make new videos that will fire passion in the history of your followers. You entertain them, you influence them.
How?
Grab those phones of yours, not that you ever put them down, and hold my hand. I'll hang on tight. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
Okay, that should be an exciting enough scene to keep you awake for another 5 minutes. Magic Alexa and a bit of time travel. What's not to like?
Yes, time travel. You heard it. See what good manners can achieve. So, dual phone and Alexa arrived smack bang in a classroom of all places in 1838. That's the start of the Victorian age, for those who didn't know.
Pardon, sir, but is it?
So that's why he's been like that, is it? Burning hysteria.
No, the Gothic pins of it can be covered down the chimney. That's why I'm a bit worried.
Well, by answering the boss's method, I too find that children learn the rules quicker when encouragement is directed towards certain parts of the body. In that end, Jemima Bennett, follow me. The rest of you work in silence.
Just a pittance of pay, and most of the jobs that I have at 5 years old, I was Khufu, or Cheops as he was also known, has just died and his body has been prepared for burial.
Whoa! Welcome to Memphis.
Who?
Not Memphis, Tennessee. This is the ancient capital city of Egypt. Right, cameras out.
Alexa had brought Jim Fred to the island, a sacred tent where a high priest, Karakamek, was teaching his apprentices the process of mummification.
Marcia, Holiness, we could hear you.
For heaven's sake, For heaven's sake, this mask of Anubis, god of the dead, is an important part of the ritual. A loser of King Khufu's mortal remains. Where is your sense of occasion? Whatever. All right, Holiness, ask your names. You.
Yes, Your Holiness.
Sabu.
Yes, Your Holiness.
Tutu.
Yes, Your Holiness.
And Keith. Hang on, Keith. Seriously, is that your name?
It is pronounced Peggy, Your Holiness.
Alright, this is your practical module of your mummification course. So, you can tell me what to do first.
Remove the frame of my head out of the nostrils.
It's all about the gory stuff that you isn't it? Typical. Why is it that most people who sign up for this course are only here for the breakthrough the nose bit?
Students today.
Your Holiness, first wash your body with the water from the Nile. May I?
Indeed you may.
There, our great King Khufu is cleansed.
Go on then, Yu, before you burst, hook out his brain.
We shan't be using that anymore.
Excuse me, Your Holiness. I wonder if I could skip the practical part of the course and just learn the theory?
Hard to stomach, isn't it, Tutu? Speaking of which, that's the part that needs to come out next, along with the liver, lungs, and intestines. Go on then. You and Keith can have a go at that. Grab a knife each. Behold, our
ready to enter the afterlife, seven, the mask. Before we engage the royal remains of the magnificent sarcophagus and lay it to rest in its pyramid tomb, please go through with servants and trainers. Please maybe go through once more. I want to be sure I've understood everything before our exams.
You really are looking to get yarn at me.
Yes, I can see that a song can be a great aid to learning and remembering. So, if you'd like to sing along.
So, this
In their very first reign in Britain, in 792, the Vikings looted the holy island of Lindisfarne, stealing many treasures, murdering monks, and enslaving the rest.
In the following century, from their homes in Scandinavia, they had made repeated raids and invasions until they had ruled a large part of Britain, which they named Danelaw. They had a fearsome reputation.
My workshop in the news.
Pretty, isn't it?
It sure is.
No.
like us, but we also still want them to respect us. So, come on. Anything else before we leave?
Well, there's music to be out by now, which is always a conversion and sensitivity. And just so happens, I'm an amateur singer, songwriter myself. So here's a little ditty to help everyone look at us in a new light.
Thank you. definitely a wig. That she was indeed very white, but this was heavy lead-based makeup.
This makeup was used to cover up the scars she'd been left with after catching smallpox in 1562. She'd been regarded as a great beauty in her younger years, and she was keen that this image was maintained.
I'm not listening to you. I told you I like it.
But Your Majesty, all we're trying to say is that makes you just go a little bit easier on the makeup.
It makes you look a little scary and could be the reason you haven't found yourself a husband yet.
La 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 la, still not listening.
You know, at this rate, you'll die in childless and England won't have a successor to the throne of both country into chaos.
Oh goodness sake, will you stop blathering on about me getting married and having babies? I've already got suitors pestering me from dusk till dawn without you going on about it.
Speaking of which, there's another one waiting outside. It's that Sir Walter Camp. Again, he's very clean.
Ooh, quite a dish that one. Looks good and tight, and that little baby dog I want is quite fetching.
And more importantly, he always brings presents. Something exotic from his latest voyage to the new world. Shall I show you him?
Yes, I suppose so. But I keep telling you, I'm really not fussed about finding a husband. Okay, how do I look?
Gorgeous, Your Majesty. I'll go and fetch her.
Your Majesty, your beauty has not faded since the last I've had the honour of being in your company. During my epic voyages to far corners of the globe, I've never witnessed such radiance. I see you, my good Queen Bess.
Don't call me that. Makes me sound like a horse.
So, why are you here?
I bring gifts from the New World, Your Majesty. From the colonies of the land, we name Virginia in your honour. I have...
Hang on. It's back to the potato again, isn't it?
You brought those last time you were here, and Her Majesty was not impressed. Out of all the things you could have brought back, you basically succeeded in introducing chips and facts. Not very legacy, is it?
Well, I...
Oh, Sir Walter, this better not be another lame attempt to get me to marry you. Like the time when you spread your expensive cloak over a pudding for me, and thought I'd all weak out of me.
Oh, I thought that was a lovely gesture. I would have said yes in a flash.
Well, you can't blame a chap for trying, and England must have an heir.
England must have an heir. Give me strength, I'm 56 years old. Honestly, I heard the Francis Drake in here recently.
Ooh, I like him too.
And he wouldn't shut up about how he led my name to victory over the Spanish Armada last year, and surely deserved my hand in marriage.
But what a victory, Your Majesty. Oh, go on, give us a bit of that speech you made to the troops at Tilbury before the battle. It was all inspiring.
Okay, if you insist. I may have the body of a weak, feeble woman, but of a heart and a stomach of a king, and of a king of England too.
And every king needs a queen. I mean, every queen needs a king. What I'm trying to say is...
I know what you're trying to say, Sir Walter, but I don't want a husband. I'm the greatest monarch England has ever known. They call me Gloriana, for heaven's sake. It doesn't get much greater than that. My name defeated the Spanish Armada. I have made our nation prosperous and brought peace and religious tolerance.
So that's not... mention how you sort of
married
from Scott.
Bit of a blip, that one. Not my finest moment, but the theatre and arts have flourished under my reign. New lands have been discovered and claimed in my name. This will be known as a golden age in our history, and I don't want only a man messing that all up.
But surely Her Majesty doesn't want to be lonely at her old age.
Lonely in my old age? It's because I'm single I've lived this long. Let me tell you about a strange visitation I had just a few nights ago. Then you'll understand. I was lying in my bed and she appeared.
Elizabeth, I propose to your mother, Anne Boleyn. fellas. They're a nightmare. Your father, for example, promised me the world, and just because I didn't have a male child, he chopped my head off. Typical man he was. Spoiled, rotten, and a crybaby when he lived in his own way. No, my girl, you stay single. It's the only way you can be assured of quality and quantity of life. Keep wearing that makeup too. It'll keep the men away. Oh, and these are rough, not for any reason apart from it makes you look daft. Right, see your pick.
Well, she's got a point, I suppose. Maybe you should take her advice.
Oh, I intend to. I'm married to Aitlin, and that's the way it can stay. And she was right about this, bruh. I'd hate to be remembered for wearing such a ridiculous thing.
Near the British trenches in Egypt.
Crown 5 months after the start of the First World War. The reason there is no gunfire is because this was the famous Christmas truce. Soldiers from both sides shouted messages of goodwill across no man's land to their enemies.
They sang carols, lit candles, and all along the Western Front, emerged from their trenches to shake hands and exchange drinks, chocolates, and cigarettes. They showed each other photos of their families and shared their hopes that this terrible war would soon be over.
Wow, the First World War! We learned a lot about this in school. And here we are in the middle of it.
Well, in a field hospital, I don't think we need to see any actual fighting, just to understand how awful things are here. Right, camera's out.
There, I'll fix your lip. If only your injury in this war is a twisted ankle, then you'll be one of the lucky ones.
Thank you, nurse. Yes, I know things could have been a lot worse.
That's a nasty gash you suffered. How did it happen?
1 minute it was calm, the next the Germans were on top of us. We didn't stand a chance.
You poor boy, I think you're concussed. Let's get you sorted.
I don't know what happened. They cut for our defences. It wasn't even there. And I got an elbow in the face.
An elbow? It's strange that none of these injuries from exploding shell and gunfire. In fact, why is it so quiet out there? What's going on?
Fighting stopped when we met the Germans of no man's land. They're just like us, you know, fighting cold and missing home.
Hang on, if the fighting stopped, why is your people in your injuries?
I was thinking the same thing. It's not much of a truce if they're set up with our boys.
There, take some slow deep breath. You're badly winded.
No, no, cheating Germans, man. Punch a chap in the ribs is unacceptable behaviour. You should have gone straight off for that.
Eh? What do you mean gone straight off? What's going on?
It's a boss. They just don't play fair. And after that friendly meet-up we had in no man's land, I thought it would be a gentle kickabout.
Kickabout?
You've been playing football in the middle of a war with the enemy?
Well, we were playing football, but I didn't know what the Germans were doing. Foul after foul after foul. Captain Simmons, he's one of us. He didn't blow his whistle once.
You boys, what do you like? Even when the fighting stopped, you still find a way to get yourself bashed in a bruise.
It was nice, though, to share a drink and to smoke with friends and to hear about their loved ones at home. And to simply wish them a Merry Christmas.
Remember when we signed up to fight? They told us that we would be over by Christmas. I can't see any end to this.
And the friends we've already lost, so many, so young, and for what? A few yards of mud and scorched earth.
I want to go home. I'm supposed to meet Aunt Rosie. Nurse, there's a letter in my pocket which I read when I'm crying to the sun. Please could you read it for me now? I would, but...
Of course. My dearest Jack, I miss you with all my heart. I pray for your safe and your return soon. You and all your pals had left on the train that day. Smiles on your faces and the excitement in your voices. I can't imagine the horror you went to have break about you told them. Stay safe and stay strong, my love. Your Rosie.
Just
me and the boy. To learn numbers to climb, out in the trenches we wait for the sign. To pick up our rifles together, just me and the boy.
Then if you're blown away by the bits you see, see, which we know you will be. Get yourself down to the museum where you can watch our journey in full on the big screen. We'll be there to answer questions and show you all the cool things we collected in our travels, like this real Egyptian mummy mask, or this strange thing that Queen Elizabeth I actually wore. It's true, we were there. Doors open in an hour. Get there quick to avoid disappointment. See you soon. I'm proud of you both, so proud. Now off you go and wow them in person. But you have to come too. This whole thing wouldn't have happened without you. I'm afraid you have to do this last bit on your own. I'm off for a well-deserved snooze. Goodbye, Jill and Fred. It's been a blast. Shall we? Let's do this.
And what a reaction they got. Moments after posting their footage, hundreds of Jill and Fred fans descended on the museum.
This is amazing. It looks so real. That brain's coming out of the nose. Awesome.
And those Vikings, who knew they were so sophisticated? How do you reckon the last line of that limerick ended?
Ha, crudely, I'm guessing.
What about Elizabeth I?
What a woman.
Can't wait to find out more about her.
And the Victorians. Those kids were proper tough. I'll tell you what, I never complained about getting out of school again.
And hearing from the soldiers in the trenches, I can't believe what they went through. The next time I buy a puppy, it's going to mean a whole lot more. This is totally the best thing Jill and Fred have ever done.
Oh, Jill, Fred, how can we ever thank you? Look at these crowds. Our museum's never been so busy.
I don't know how you did it, but I'm glad you did. This has saved us. We can stay open. We can show everyone how amazing the past was. We can make people fall in love with history again.
You'll never know how happy you've made us. Oh, and if you're wondering if doing the same sort of thing again, the museum's still short on some stuff.
The Great Fire of London, the Black Death, World War II, crikey grammar, that sounds like a fun trip. I can't see Alexa turning up for that one.
Alexa? Who's out there? A friend of yours?
Ha, you can say that, yes. I'll introduce you sometime. She's the hero of this adventure.
And the amazing characters we met along the way. They're the real stars. The ones who laid the foundations for all the wonderful things we have today. The explorers, the inventors, the soldiers, the peacemakers, the pioneers. All of them. Here's to the ones who went before.
Stay at home to raise a family.
to reach our promised land. We'll build a future worth living for. And those who follow on will find the better world we've left behind. They'll keep our fire burning strong. You held and turned the key, and forever you